Hi everyone, so in this video we are going to discuss Windows 365 Cloud PCs, what they are, why you would need to use them, using the different versions available, and we will look into some comparisons with Azure Virtual Desktop and a demo creating and accessing a Windows 365 Cloud PC. So what actually is a Cloud PC? So if we think about a traditional physical desktop, or a PC hosted on a physical machine, this is normally accessed by users from one location. This is a restriction for access as cloud PCs are accessible anywhere at any time, not to mention the physical desktop support and business needing to have an on-site IT technicians available to repair issues. Since virtual desktops or cloud PCs are hosted at a data center, they are more secure and can utilize all the benefits of multi-factor authentication and conditional access. If more storage or performance is needed, we can easily add this via the portal, whereas physical desktops require you to purchase hard drives and upgrades. With a Windows 365 cloud-based PC, your entire operating system and everything that's installed on it is located in the cloud instead of your own device's hard drive. You can then access a cloud PC through either the Windows 365 app, the client, or web browser accessible from anywhere on any device. We can reduce the cost of the devices to access the cloud PC by using a minimalist endpoint device such as a thin client to connect to the cloud PC. Software upgrades can be managed in a central location and rolled out easily using Intune if required. Your cloud PC, it lives on a remote server in an Azure data center and you connect to it via the internet, and your desktop files and applications are available to you on any device, anytime and anywhere. Protecting against security risks and providing better data protection with compliant cloud PCs, we get a complete and full personalized Windows experience on any device, Windows, Mac, iOS, or Android. It allows you to use multiple operating systems, access and run any heavy application with the same experience you expect from physical computers. We are not limited to hardware resources like our fixed hardware, and we may have the challenge of requiring more compute, memory, or storage resources to play a demanding game or working on a project and using a new application that needs greater resources. In these scenarios, with a physical PC, we would need to order the hardware, get it delivered, and then physically upgrade that device, which is often a timely and costly process. Windows 365 allows you to subscribe to a cloud PC at a fixed monthly cost, which can run your typical applications like Outlook, Teams, Excel, Word, and you can give it access to the data contained in the cloud located in the SharePoint and OneDrive. So this is a managed device dedicated to a single person as a personal device. Windows 365 Cloud PC, it runs all the time, 24/7, except Frontline plans, which would explain the different versions available later on. And shutting them down does not save any cost as it's a fixed cost. Cloud PCs, they are billed in a per user, per month cost model. And this model means your organization doesn't have to manage the variability of compute and storage costs of a traditional hosted desktop model. So Windows 365 is easier to deploy and manage. It's also more cost effective if there are a small number of desktops, less than 10, in the cloud environment. We don't need any Active Directory configuration or storage for FX Logic's profiles. It doesn't require a specialized skill set to manage and configure and offers ease of deployment, management and cost savings if your environment is small, around 5 to 10 users. So it provides a very simple to run a cloud PC, and you can deploy cloud PCs alongside existing physical PCs, which all the flexibility, scalability, security that brings with it, and access your cloud PC from anywhere. Now in the next section, let's take a look at the different versions available to us. There are three versions of Windows 365 Cloud PCs. We have Windows 365 for Business, Windows 365 for Enterprise, and Windows 365 Frontline. With Windows 365 Cloud PCs for Business, they are basic and they offer simplicity for smaller companies. They are fast to set up and they do not require an Azure subscription or footprint. There is no dependency against Active Directory and also no licensing requirements to buy and deploy Windows 365 Business. If your organization needs a connection to an existing corporate network, you'll need to choose the Enterprise Edition. Also, outbound data per month may be restricted when levels are exceeded, which is measured based upon the RAM of the client PC. So Windows 365 Frontline is for workers that need access to a cloud PC only for a limited amount of time, for example, during their shift and not after working hours, part-time, or for limited periods. So each worker will receive a unique Frontline cloud PC, but licenses are shared. Shift workers, they don't normally require 24/7 access to their cloud PCs. Therefore, with Windows 365 Frontline, you don't need to purchase a cloud PC for every employee. You only need enough cloud PCs for the maximum number of active users at any given time, providing cost benefits and a cost reduction. When a shift worker logs in, the Frontline cloud PC is powered on and the license is used for the duration of their work. So when they log off, the shared licenses then return to the pool of shared licenses and their Frontline cloud PC is powered off. So Windows 365 Frontline licenses will show up in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center under the Products tab and do not need to be assigned to specific users. Enterprise cloud PC setup are more complex and provisioning is configurable and customizable to the needs of the organization. Each user must be licensed for Windows 10 or 11 Enterprise, Microsoft Intune, and Microsoft Entra ID P1. And we can provision cloud PCs by using a standard gallery images or custom images. And GPO, group policy objects, they are supported and also can be managed using Intune. A connection to a corporate network is possible together with Azure AD Join, with or without VNet support, and hybrid Azure AD Join with VNet support. Check out the links in the description for more information comparing Windows 365 Business and Enterprise and Frontline Cloud PCs in the Microsoft article. Links are in the description below. Now let's talk about comparing Windows 365 Cloud PCs to Azure Virtual Desktop. So if you have more than 10 users and a more complex environment with customized applications, which are designed and developed as per your business requirements, you want to consider Azure Virtual Desktop. To give you that scalability beyond just deploying a single cloud PC for a single user as a dedicated personal device. With Azure Virtual Desktop, you may have a current Azure footprint or one planned, and you may already be running your identity in the cloud, such as synced Active Directory domain services to Entra ID, or you may be running pure Azure Active Directory domain services in the cloud. You may need published applications rather than a full Windows desktop session, and also a pool of desktops with load balancing requirements and FX Logic user profiles. We have covered a complete step-by-step guide and demo showing Azure Virtual Desktop how to set up, configure, and implement from start a fully working AVD solution using FX Logic profiles with Azure Premium Storage and private endpoints with Active Directory integration. This will help you build a virtualized desktop infrastructure VDI solution at enterprise scale from start to finish. So check out the video in the description if you need more information on that and for a full comparison against Windows 365 cloud PCs and a demo in this video. In this video, in the next section, we will give a demo on provisioning a simple Windows 365 cloud PC as a personal desktop and see what options are available and assign a business cloud PC license to a user in the Windows 365 admin portal, and we will provision a desktop within minutes. Then the user can log in to start using their new cloud PC. Let's take a look in the next section. Let's create our new Windows 365 Cloud PC. So as an admin, we go to admin.microsoft.com, billing, purchase services, and then we click Windows 365. Here we can see the versions available to us, Enterprise, Business and Frontline, and Business with Hybrid Benefit. So we will choose Hybrid Benefit as we have a Windows 11 Pro licensed on our primary work device. With Hybrid Benefit, this will also give us a discount. We select the free trial on a 1 month term and confirm we are using a valid license on the primary device for access. And this will give you a Windows 11 Cloud PC on a trial basis for a month with 2 CPU, 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. And after a month, we can cancel to avoid getting charged for this. We now have our trial license, so let's assign this to our cloud admin user. And now let's check out in the next section how to access our cloud PC. Okay, good. So we have our cloud PC provisioned and we can access this using the Windows app on the web through a browser at windows365.microsoft.com, through the remote desktop client or through LG Web OS. We will install the Windows app on our device and we search for Windows 365 in the Microsoft Store on our local device. And we are logged in as Cloud Admin User, who we assign the license to. And as you can see, we have our Cloud PC available to us. We click Connect, we approve the request and we log in to use it. We have a fully functional Windows 11 Enterprise PC in the cloud with local drive redirection to our local drives also. We can install apps here, for example Firefox, and we can see the CPU and memory available and we can scale this up if needing more resources. We can also access the Cloud PC via windows365.microsoft.com and open in a browser and we get session settings and we can direct our printers, file transfer and other local devices. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to the video. It really does help the channel grow and it's appreciated. So all the best. Hope you enjoyed the video and see you next time. Bye for now.